sä et ole vähän aikaa puhunut mitään. How to do a corporate video?
Ei huono. Hey guys, we just got done shooting a reference video that I told you earlier on. I'm here with the client, Kaisa!
Hello!
What would you like to know about me or my trade? Q&A. Ask me some. Q&A. This is your chance to ask me my opinion on something. What would
First question. I've always wondered how you're so natural behind the camera. Like, what takes all the anxiety and all that nerves away when you're shooting these videos? Because usually, if people shoot a video, they're not themselves at all. So, that's my question.
That is actually a really good question. And I have been struggling. I don't know if you guys know, but first thing first you have to do it a lot. You don't have to publish all things, but you have to talk to the camera a lot. Like, I've done multiple videos that are never been published, but I see myself in it, I can hear myself, and I get familiarized with my voice and with my how I look, and with time you get used to it, which kind of releases your personality. What I do struggle, and not many people know about this, but I do struggle, I have this alias, a second persona, that when I'm on video, I tend to be more, I tend to unconsciously go into this sort of presentator mode. And that shows, even though it's a little bit personality, but that's still, I'm more quirky. I'm more quirky than these videos let me show. So.
Yeah, I know that.
But, practice. A lot of time.
So can you like notice or can you tell when you look at the earlier videos when you haven't been yourself and now you look at these videos where you are exactly who you are and you are like a professional on video. So can you notice what has been the change? Like is there any gestures you do or is your voice different?
Yes, I tend to speak a lot with my hands. If you look at the earlier videos, I'm like doing all kinds of things with my hands and it's quite distracting. So I take notice of that and I try to keep them in line. Like, I don't want to eliminate it because it's fine. It's part of me. I speak with my hands. I'm animated, but it has to be toned down so it's not distracting. And with the one thing that has been, if I think about my childhood and youth, like when I was younger, I spoke very like unclear. I was mumbling. And now if you listen to my voice and what I say, I try to pay attention to my articulation that people can understand what I'm saying. And that has been like the biggest change throughout the years. Like, it's been an awesome practice as a speaking or doing keynotes or whatever. This video making has given me such a good foundation for that.
Okay, so let's say I want to be a vlogger. So I want to start my own YouTube channel or I just want to start to post videos. Mm. So give me 3 tips how to be more natural on camera.
You're good. Good questions. Excellent questions, man. 3 tips. Well, one thing, the first thing I would say is take time to practice. Like, And kind of, I used to say good enough is the new perfect. Okay, I would shift that a little bit in a sense that there has to be value, but the value doesn't have to be a production value. It can be a tip, or it can be a tutorial, or it can be something that people can relate to. That's value. It's always educational, informational, or then just emotional that people find value. So I say take some time, practice, that's number one. Number two would be, before you start doing bigger things, master the little things. Like, master talking to the camera, like looking at the lens instead of looking up or wherever your screen might be. Like, just focus and treat your camera like a friend. And that takes a lot of practice to be able to talk to a camera like you would talk to a person. So practice on talking to a camera. Little things before you start going to big things. Third one would be try out a lot of different things to find your own niche. I used to say that you're finding your niche is like finding love, like it comes when you least expect it to. And that's kind of like how I found what I like to do. I've been trying a lot of different things. And then I start naturally gravitating towards one or two things that I've been continuously doing. And when it's in line with yourself and with your own motives, it doesn't strain you. It doesn't take your strength away, or it doesn't consume energy. You enjoy it and you like to do it and you keep on doing it, because YouTubing is not a short-term game. It's very long-term. You have to have patience. I think patience is number one thing you have to have with the vlogging thing when you start. There's a lot of content out there, so to be able to race above the rest is just a strategy, planning, hard work, dedication, all that good stuff. Patience above all, and there you have it.
People usually say that you are the worst critic of yourself, right?
That's damn right.
So basically what you need to do is you need to get a test audience for your videos, because if you rate your videos to be the worst ever, but then you show it to your friends or your family who know you, who know all your gestures, who know how you usually talk, they can tell you whether you're faking or not.
Absolutely.
So have you done that?
Yes, I have. And sorry. Yes, I have. I ask opinions from my wife. She's a very good supporter, and I trust her opinion, and she knows me better than I do. So her feedback is invaluable. Like, it is the foundation for all of this. But I do, like, when I first started, I just decided that no matter what the outcome is, I'm just gonna put my stuff out there, and people either like it or they hate it. But as long as I can influence even one person, it's worth it. And it's kind of like when you take the ego out of the equation, you start kind of seeing the bigger picture, is that like, it's not about you, it's about the listener. And the listener is the only one who matters at this. Mm-hmm. That's why the value is so important. Like, I try to give as much value as possible with my videos. And there's a long way still to go. Like, my storytelling is, you know, I need practice, and I know that. But every time my red string, or the founding idea, is that give something valuable. Mm-hmm. Because that's ultimately, like, nobody's watching you because it's the emotional connection. But I feel like if there's something extra in there, like there's something valuable to take away, then I've done my job right.
All right. You mentioned ego earlier, so I'm thinking, okay, if you're shy or you're not confident, you're not a confident person, but you would like to start a vlog, so how can you do that? Do you need to build a confidence first to start doing it? Or can a shy person do a vlog, but from a different point of view?
I think shy people can do vlogs just fine. I think it's all about, like, positioning yourself with the rest. Like, you don't have to compete with outgoing and crazy and animated people. You have your own, you're your own person. And there are probably a million other shy people who would relate to your vlog, and they would find strength in that. So I think it's not matter of your output and the way you speak. I think it's still the content and the value you give out is the key. Like, if you're shy, you can tell about the fight you're having with publishing vlogs and what things you have you done to encourage yourself to speak up and talk to a camera. Or it could be in kind of like social point of view. What kind of daily struggles do you have? What things are consuming your energy, and how have you recollected that, or how do you find peace in public places, or whatever. You know, those are valuable things for introverts. So then it becomes like you position yourself in such a place that, you know, it's the audience is know that this is the place for them, mm-hmm. instead of the other way around. So it's, I think that's like comes down to the strategy part. Like, what's your unique angle? What's your unique value? You know, UVP, if you go to marketing terms, like unique value proposal. Like, it's all about finding your niche and your target audience and really keeping in that framework.
So have you always been this confident? If you think about your childhood, were you the one who were always presenting? You were in a group and you were the one who were presenting all your work to others? Or did it just happen in your adulthood that you realized that, hey, I can actually do this? Like, I'm a good vlogger.
Funnily enough, I was a very quiet child. Like, if you ask my parents, my family, they think that I'm the quietest guy there was. And, you know, I got a lot of times I got out of trouble because they thought that I was the quiet child and I would never do anything. Disclaimer. I don't know. I guess I found this passion for vlogging in my adulthood, you know? And it's part of growing the confidence and just part of that decision making, like, you know what, this is what I like to do and this is what I'm gonna do. And then publishing few of the times I started last year with my blog at the same time. And it's kind of like the more you publish and more comfortable you get with yourself, and when you start getting that positive feedback, it just starts creating and pumping that confidence in you. So I would say, like, when we think too much, like, oh, you know, I'm not so good, or I don't have anything to say, we're downplaying our value. And that's kind of like, you should just forget about that. Like, if you're a professional, like, if I'm thinking P2B field and the experts and all people, they always downplay their knowledge. Well, I don't know really, can I say anything? But what you know is completely unknown for others. So even the simplest things that you bring to the table and say, you know what, I found by my experience this to be the best way, even in simple terms, there are tons of people who find that valuable. So whatever we have to say, somebody will find value in that. And I think we have to remember that big picture again, that there's always audience ready to be listening to what you have to say.
Okay, my last question to you is how to grow your audience. Because you don't want to settle on having 100 or 1,000 viewers on a vlog. So yeah. How can you grow your audience? So how can you make a brand of yourself?
I like a strategy called SES. It's shoot, curate, and share. So basically it's like, when you find, you do a strategic plan, like social media is a great platform and one channel is not enough. We can create as like perfect content, but if nobody knows it's existing, well, it's as good as nothing. So I think we have to do this sort of omni-channel or multi-channel or whatever. Like, we have to create a cross-platform strategy for curation and sharing. So that's like, we have to be kind of aggressive the way we promote it. Again, find your niche, find your audience, and find the channels that they are using, and then focus your promotion into those channels. And promotion is a bad word, it's giving value. Like my vlogs, I try to create value, so I'm saying, hey, here are something that you might find valuable, please comment if I miss something, or, you know, it's not like, hey, watch my vlog. So I'm doing a favor, at least in my own head, and that's the foundation for strategy. And then just find others to collaborate, you know, use not only your own network, but use people around you who are doing similar things, not maybe things that are exactly the same, but, you know, there's a lot of networking opportunities. If you would say that, hey, I want to start a vlog, and you ask me like, hey, can we collaborate? I would say, heck yeah. Like, I'm open. Like, I'm always open for new things and new people. And I do believe in the saying of Jeff Bulas, is that your network is your net worth. So I'm always finding new ways to find new people and get in touch with people. And yeah. But I say shoot, curate, and share, and collaborate. Thank you, guys. Very good questions, man. I like this Q&A stuff. Please comment below if you want more of this Q&A, because this was quite fun. So if you guys want it, show it by liking or commenting below, and I will arrange it for you guys. This was fun.